Well, from the South Orange County Community College District, we have the board president with us today, TJ Pendergast. And TJ, so many good things are happening at really in the community colleges in general, but at South Orange County Community College District, lots of great stuff going on. At Saddleback in particular, they're having the new stadium and just great stuff going at ATEP and over at IVC. It's a wonderful district, it really is.
Yeah, it's an exciting time. We have, like you said, we have a lot of great projects going and a lot of advancements in what we're offering to the students at all levels.
Yeah, so welcome, great to have you here. Now you, although you folks are serve certain district areas, you all work together. You all kind of oversee different things, and but your service area south is North Tustin, Tustin, Santa Ana, Irvine, and some incorporated areas. But again, you folks all kind of you're all elected at large. Am I right?
Correct.
Yeah.
So you have to live in one of the seven areas, but you run throughout the entire district for re-election or general election.
Right. So glad you're on the board. So one of the things that's been in the news recently as far as the budgets go for Community College District is looking at increasing some of the, I guess it would be college for all type thing, but really giving the local community college districts a little more funding to be able to give back to the students and kind of oversee some of the costs that they put out, right?
Certainly. We have the College Promise Program that's an effort to try and waive for tuition for students that are in need, as well as show the aptitude academically.
Right.
And if they stay on a certain path, they have that covered.
Oh, that's
which
nice.
A lot of the new funding is to help that College Promise Program go into a second year. We pretty much started it last year.
Okay.
Up and down the state.
So this isn't a program where everyone just automatically gets community college for free. It's, you know, there's certain parameters that they have to meet and go through.
Correct.
Almost in a sense, sort of like a state-sponsored scholarship type thing, because a lot of scholarships with universities, you know, you got to have your grades up and keep, there's certain parameters that the student has to
certainly, yeah.
Follow.
It is academic-based, but it's also need-based.
Right.
And it's, each college can determine its parameters for which it wants the students to go through. Everyone does it a little bit differently. We of course think the way we're doing it is really well done. So so far it's been very successful.
And along with that, in general, there's been some additional funding for community colleges as well.
Correct. Yeah. In general, they increased. We're still a little behind the funding model that used to exist in 2008 before the recession. I think that exists at the K through 12s as well. No one's gotten back to fulfill the funding level that they were at then.
Right.
But both at the K through 12 and at the community college level, the state has come up with new ways of funding that they think is more fair.
Right.
And definitely reaches out to help disadvantaged students, either due to language, socioeconomic, or foster youth in that sense, to try and help some of those non-academic barriers that we see so much more these days.
Okay, and also some funding for the Gateway building on Saddleback campus. And what is that? Is like the main administration building?
So we have gone through a long period where the state wasn't matching funds for construction. So if you wanted to build new buildings, you either had to fund them entirely yourselves or go out for a bond and things of that nature. So we've been fortunate enough through our funding model in our district to be able to do some of that. But but projects the size of the Gateway building, which is, it's kind of a hub for the students and the faculty and administration to be able to get things done.
All right, very good. Now, also when it comes to student housing and food insecurities, are these, you look at an individual and have grants for them, or how does the student housing work? Because I know It's not something that you folks have on campus.
We're working on that. Okay. So right now we've got a study to mm-hmm. see what really exists out there.
Okay.
How many homeless students do we have? How many students are dealing with food insecurities? Mm-hmm. So maybe they have a place to live, but they, you know, have a hard time paying the bills and, you know, feeding themselves and maybe a small family.
Okay.
And we're just going to see, we have to find the data first and
yeah,
then see
yeah.
what it is that we have the capabilities to do financially and or physically.
Okay. All right. So that's something in the future you'll look at and see
yes.
what can be done. Now, here's a great program. This is the 32nd annual Astounding Inventions event. This is really neat because this works with K through 8 students, and it really goes along with the STEAM program, and they get to invent things and have fun, and then you showcase that, right?
Absolutely. I've actually been a part of that program now for 15 years because my own daughters were in it.
Okay.
And had inventions, and then when I became a trustee, it was a really exciting to be kind of in the background and part of how it develops, and it's really exciting to see how these children come up with these ideas
yeah.
and then move on. There was one young boy who won the top level prize in fourth grade
mm-hmm.
and was there again in sixth grade pitching a new product, but in between the judging and the awards, he was over in the PAC basically selling his past invention to people who were interested in it.
Wow.
He was marketing it and had it going. It was really impressive.
Yeah.
And then we were talking, and I was able to say in my opening speech that, you know, my own daughters have gone into STEM and mm-hmm. they're friends. They have one friend who's going to be automotive engineer and another one who's biotech engineering. And we just started thinking about it. It's like, how could we maybe track
yeah.
in the 32 years of this, how many of those students have
yeah.
been inspired to go on into science or math or engineering or technology?
Yeah, that's amazing. And it's a great program because kids really get enthused on things like that. And I think when it comes to a lot of times at a younger age like that, their minds are freer. They're not thinking about how am I going to market this. I mean, that one kid obviously did. But they're just thinking like, this would be a good idea. You know, let's put this out there. And, you know, from there, things can progress. But they're just come up with some wonderful ideas that they see a need for. Like, why isn't
Certainly.
This done this way?
And I think it's in many ways, a lot better than a science fair.
Yeah.
It's because they're trying to solve a problem.
Yeah, yeah.
They're trying, and it may be science-based, but it doesn't have to be.
Yeah.
It can be anything from, you know, we saw kids with special shoes that would do, you know, like almost like a Swiss Army knife. It would have tools in the shoe. Or,
yeah.
Or a mop that
We're
has...
We're seeing some of the...
a mop yeah. that has all of the attachments to it. Or a lawnmower that has, you know, weed killer
yeah.
and grass seed compartments on it so you can take care of that while you're mowing the lawn.
Yeah.
Just, you know, and makes you wonder where they found that need.
You know, that kid probably had to mow the lawn,
yeah.
and then the parents said, you know what, we got to put seed on there, go out there. And he's like, wait a minute.
You just never know. Yeah,
look at this kid here, tackle tamer, and coming up with a, you know, I guess like a tackle box, and
mm-hmm.
probably figuring out this is a better way to do this. And I think
Absolutely.
This is wonderful.
You can always build a better mousetrap, right?
Yeah. Now, do they get prizes for this or any kind of scholarships?
Certainly.
How does
so,
that work?
So the top level winners, I believe, get $50
mm-hmm.
if they get a first place.
Yeah.
I believe second place gets $25. And all that's funded by the sponsors. And then they pick, I believe, 4 top level winners to go to the law firm that sponsors the event to ultimately pick one person who gets a free patent
wow.
application.
Wow.
The law firm pro bono
yeah.
helps them get a patent.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
What a wonderful program. And this goes on once a year in January?
Once a year in January.
Okay. That is really cool. I like that. Now, 50th anniversary of Saddleback College. and you wanted to, actually that was like a couple years ago, am I right?
It's still ongoing.
Okay.
It's this year is the is
oh, it is. Kind
of
okay.
The culmination of the 50th year.
And you have something going on right now, it's called Tell Your Story, right?
Right, yeah, we're really encouraging anyone who had involvement as a student or former faculty administration to let us know what their experience was while they were in Saddleback and where they are now.
Yeah,
as a result of that experience.
Yeah, and you plan to put out like an exhibit or an online thing? What are you going to do with
the
information?
I'm not entirely sure what the ultimate product will be. They're still putting that together.
Yeah, well, of course, you know,
I guess it depends on how much
we have. You know, every few months we have Marcia on. Of course, she goes way back with them, and I'm sure she's right behind something like this.
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Very good, folks. You can go online and get more information for the South Orange County Community College District. It's right there, soccccd.edu. And from there, you can find out what's happening at Saddleback, at IVC, and ATEP. I know ATEP is moving along quite good. That is, of course, the technology center that is being done on the old Tustin Air Base, right?
Correct. We have the IDEA building there now.
Yeah.
That is a high-tech modeling, 3D modeling, robotics,
oh, fantastic,
technology center right now, and then some other projects in the works.
Very good. All right, great, and thank you for coming on. I really appreciate it. Always good to see you. Say hi to everyone for me. We'll see them again soon.
Will do.
All right, you take care. We'll be right back. Yeah, it's incredible.